Have you ever wondered why your phone doesn't just melt when you plug it in? I mean, hundreds of volts is quite a lot for a phone, right? Or how electricity can travel hundreds of kilometers to your home from a power plant almost unaffected by any resistance? The answer to both is a surprisingly simple device: the transformer. So, let's figure out how it works. The work of a transformer is based on a principle called electromagnetic induction. It's simple. An electric current creates a magnetic field around itself. So if you change the current, you change the magnetic field. But here's the crucial thing. It also works in reverse. A changing magnetic field creates an electric current. Let's apply this to two separate coils of wire placed near each other. Changing current in the first winding changes current in the second winding. But in this simple setup, the vast majority of the magnetic field doesn't reach the second winding. To fix this, we can install a core made of a magnetic material, like iron, between two coils. The iron core acts like a highway for the magnetic field, guiding it perfectly from the first coil to the second. This way, almost no energy is wasted. By the way, this is how a regular transformer looks like if we ignore some secondary components. The main purpose of a transformer, which is to change voltage, is achieved by changing the ratio of turns of the windings. If the secondary winding has twice as many turns as the primary, then its voltage will also be twice as high. This happens because the magnetic field exerts force on each turn of the coil. So the more turns the coil has, the greater the resulting force and voltage in the winding. This is because voltage is the work done to move a charge. The magnetic field, by exerting more force, does more work and consequently creates a higher voltage. An important detail of a transformer's work is that it doesn't change power in the circuit. As voltage times current equals power, an increase in voltage causes a proportional decrease in current in order to leave the power unchanged. The most common use of transformers is to change voltage in a power grid. In power grids which are directly connected to a power plant, power is constant. In this case, higher voltage helps to reduce losses of energy due to heating of wire almost completely. To understand why heat depends on voltage, or, more exactly, current, let's see what it means for an object to have a temperature. A temperature of an object represents the sum of the kinetic energies of all molecules or atoms of the object. So, during an electrical flow, electrons collide with multiple molecules or atoms of the conductor, transferring some of their kinetic energy to them, which consequently causes heating of the conductor. Therefore, the more electrons flow, which is what current actually represents, the more collisions occur, and eventually the conductor's temperature also becomes higher. So, in cases with constant power, energy losses due to heat can be significantly decreased by decreasing the current, which is achieved by increasing the voltage. Another common example of a transformer is a phone charger. However, this time power is not constant, as the charger gets as much power as it needs. Using Ohm's law and substituting its product in the power equation, we find out that power directed to the phone depends only on the voltage and the resistance of the phone. Using European voltage of 230 volts and resistance of 3 ohms, we get enormous and just unmanageable amounts of energy. The vast majority of the power will heat your phone extremely, causing its inevitable burning. However, we can decrease the amount of power by decreasing voltage, which is what the transformer does in this case. So it turns out that this simple device made of two coils and a piece of iron is completely indispensable in modern energy, allowing us to safely charge phones and transmit gigawatts of energy over thousands of kilometers.